News Center 5. Coverage you can count on.
Native Americans believed it was haunted, a desolate island, mysterious, cold. Then America's toughest criminals were sent here when no other place could hold them. No one ever escaped from Alcatraz. But today, over 500 elite athletes challenge the notorious waters of San Francisco Bay. Race through the foggy, wet streets of San Francisco. And punish themselves along a 10-mile, rugged, grueling coastal trail in the shadow of the Golden Gate Bridge. 1994 Ironman champion, Greg Welch. Three-time Alcatraz champion, Mike Pigg. Great Britain's Simon Lessing. Along with defending women's champion, Sean Welch. And tenacious Paula Newby Frazier. They'll all attempt the 15th annual Escape from Alcatraz Triathlon.
Hello, everybody. I'm Barry Tompkins. We welcome you to an event that is unique to San Francisco. It's the Escape from Alcatraz, a 1.5-mile swim from the island of Alcatraz to the city of San Francisco. Nobody was ever able to do it when it was still a prison, remember? Then a 19-mile bike ride and a 10-mile run, just for good measure. Wasn't it Mark Twain who said, "The coldest winter I ever spent was a summer in San Francisco"? Actually, on this day, Mark might have been a little bit wrong. Since the fog has lifted, the weather's improved. Out among them, with the maddening crowd, is Greg Lewis. Greg?
Well, Barry, we've all heard that escape from Alcatraz was impossible, so how can these triathletes do it? Of course, the guards and the guns are gone, and today is one of but about 2 days a year when the currents are mild enough to actually negotiate the bay. As for the story, sharks that supposedly infest these waters, there hasn't been a shark attack since the late 50s. The real predator here is water temperature. It's in the high 50s, and that can take a very big bite out of you. For more on that, let's go to Frank Shorter on the shore.
Thanks, Greg. The organizers of this event have inserted a mandatory one-mile run between the swim finish here at Aquatic Park and the bike transition over at Fort Mason. They have to reestablish a sense of equilibrium, warm up before they begin riding. I've actually seen some of the competitors do this one-mile run, get on their bikes, begin to pedal, and fall over. It's necessary.
All right, Frank, before these competitors get to that, however, there is that anticipation. Greg Welch of Australia, he has won here back in 1992. Mike Pigg, the winner last year, the American. And Simon Lessing from Great Britain, who is starting to make a lot of noise in the triathlon events, particularly at the shorter distances. Fernanda Keller, South American champion from Brazil. Paula Newby Frazier from Zimbabwe, now living in San Diego, a two-time winner here. Might like a little bit more distance, however. And the person that everybody is talking about these days, her first try at the escape from Alcatraz, but 10 wins this year, Makili Jones. She is tough.
And this is suited for her. This is what they call a short course triathlon, not the Ironman distance. It won't take 8 hours. This will take something over 2 hours. But first, they have to try to warm up in this frigid water. The difficulty here is you jump off, swim over to the start, and then you have to just literally bob up and down in the water and wait for the horn.
Only now can these swimmers begin to get warm as this race starts. Just by way of identification, the green caps are the men professionals, the yellow caps the women professionals, pink or orange to the amateurs. Just coming around the island now, and things will start to string out a little bit. And even this early in the race, the people that are supposed to be up there are up there. Frank, tell us about this swim course.
Barry, psychologically, the swimmers all say it seems further than it is. And so the organizers time this race at a point in the season where the tides are at a minimum so they can focus on the distance rather than the currents.
If only the prisoners knew that. The race now about a quarter of a mile away from the island. Things starting to string out a little bit. That is Rip Esselstyn. No surprise there. For the last several years, he has been the leader at this point of the race. Esselstyn very tough in this portion.
He loves to come out of the water first. It really is a matter of pride. Right behind him, Simon Lesson looks like he is trying to catch up to Rip, trying to get into his wake, because you can actually draft when you're swimming.
And Rip doing all the work right now. Right on his heels, however, is Simon Lessing. And we talked to Rip about his plans of shaking Lessing.
Well, I think the only way I'll be able to shake him in the swim is if I can break free early the first 200 meters. Otherwise, he'll be right on my heels or he'll be ahead of me. He's the man to probably to beat.
Well, Frank, what do they say about the best laid plans?
And advantage Lessing at this point, because he merely wants to be at the front coming out of the water because he's trying to win the race. Rip Esselstyn, matter of pride, he just wants to be first out of the water, so he has to stay ahead. Lessing really has an advantage here.
That's Wes Hobson. He right now is in third place and a couple of amateurs alongside him. And as to the other contenders, that's Mike Pigg, Andy Kelsey, and Greg Welch swimming together.
And Greg Welch and Mike Pigg trained together a lot during the year, and so I think they've just decided to pull each other along. The racing for them between each other will start later.
Field's starting to string out a little bit. Look at the women's race, and Makili Jones right now is the leading woman, swimming very strongly.
Way out ahead. All the women expect her to be there. Perhaps she's even relishing this swim. Paula Newby-Fraser, on the other hand, more likely she's enduring it.
When I think about the swim here, I always stand out and look at Alcatraz, and I think it's not that far. But somehow when you get dumped into the water out there, it always, you know, once you start swimming, it just seems to take forever to get into Aquatic Park.
Which I'm sure was exactly the thought of a whole bunch of guys who lived on Alcatraz, not by choice when it was a federal penitentiary. It looks so close and feels so far. Here's Greg Lewis.
Well, Barry, as the swim continues, a quick bit of history. The word Alcatraz means pelican, and this island, which was hell for prisoners, has always been a haven for seabirds. But of course, for seabirds, it's a quick flight to the mainland. For prisoners, the flight to freedom was all but impossible.
In the 29 years Alcatraz Island served as a federal penitentiary, there were 36 escape attempts. The most legendary, by the infamous Frank Morris. He and the Anglin brothers used sharpened spoons to widen a vent in the wall of their cells. They fabricated cardboard grates to cover their work and prepared papier-mâché dummies to avoid the night head count. On the 11th of June, 1962, they made their break. They squeezed through the hole, up a utility corridor, and onto the roof. It's believed they challenged the swift currents of San Francisco Bay in a makeshift raft built from raincoats. Were they swept out to sea, or did they make it? If they survived, it may have been the only successful escape from the rock, but the truth may never be known.
Rip Esselstyn from the United States, plowing on ahead through the water, and Simon Lesson from Great Britain, just along for the ride.
Here's the way it looks. Esselstyn, 3 seconds to the good of Lessing. Wes Hobson, less than a minute behind. As to the women, Makili Jones, 45 seconds ahead of Paula Newby-Fraser. Holly Naibo, 52 seconds behind.
The Escape from Alcatraz Triathlon is being brought to you by Saab, Find Your Own Road. By Ultra Fuel, the ultimate carbohydrate energy drink from Twin Labs. By Sea-Doo, everybody's doing it. And by Saucony, proud to be the official shoe of the Escape from Alcatraz Triathlon. Saucony, loyal to the sport.
You could never wear a suit again. You could not laugh when it's not funny. You could go off and write that novel, climb that mountain, buy those shoes. You could fly in the face of convention or drive there. Find your own road. Saab.
Thank you. turns out, the only people who bring more to running are the runners themselves. Saucony, loyal to the sport.
How do you get from here to here? Now you can surf News Center 5 online. A hot new website on the internet. Take a virtual tour of our newsroom and meet our news team. Access Health Beat reports, get tips for your money, or cruise on the cutting edge. From consumer news to movie reviews, even details of your favorite Channel 5 shows. It's timely information 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. Tap into 5 online. That's coverage you can count on.
Sure, I do.
Yeah, and I made it today. Do you think I'm a good painter?
Of course.
What Grandpa sees has nothing to do with aging eyesight. It's a condition called low vision.
Oh, it's beautiful. What do you call it?
Grandpa, that's you.
Take control of your life. Call 1-800-334-5497 or call the Boston Aid to the Blind at 617-323-5111.
Tompkins, Frank Shorter, Greg Lewis, we welcome you back to GGP's coverage of the escape from Alcatraz. Overcast day here in San Francisco, but the fog has lifted. Water temperature's still cold. Doesn't matter, however, to Rip Esselstyn. He's in his customary position in first place. What's not customary is Simon Lessing is right alongside. Frank, what happens after the swim?
Well, Barry, how do you match the swim? Hills, wind, and sand. This is not your ordinary triathlon. They go out on the bike 19 miles along the Great Highway. There'll be wind there, back up these hills through the Presidio to Fort Scott. The run transition. Change into your running shoes. What do? Go back out and do it again. Back down, except they throw in the sand and the beaches here. And one point in particular, this almost vertical climb. Over 200 meters, back up to the highway, through the Presidio, and downtown to the finish at the Marina Green, and they'll be very happy to be here, Barry.
It all looks pretty serene, the only part of the course, in fact, that is. Meanwhile, the men are headed toward Muni Pier. That's Muni Pier on the left. Once they get in there, they got about 200 yards to go, and it is a very easy 200 yards. Rip Esselstyn still cannot shake Simon Lessing. As for the women, Greg Lewis is caught up with the leader, McKeely Jones. What's happening in that race?
Some problems early on for Sean Welch, who won the Escape from Alcatraz triathlon last year. She hit the water, she had some difficulties with her goggles, and as she was trying to adjust them, a couple of male swimmers went right over the top of her. It really appeared to unsettle her. Now she's at least 100 yards behind as we get close to the shore.
So with the intimidating presence of the island now behind them, these swimmers have now done what no one ever did when the federal government ran the place. When Alcatraz was at its most notorious, America was going through perhaps its most gregarious era. The rock was for the most incorrigible, the ones above and beyond the law, the ones society most wanted to forget. The 1920s brought depression and prohibition to this country. It was an era when bank robberies, kidnappings, and bootlegging made daily headlines. No prison walls were strong enough or high enough to hold these villains. Authorities were ready to retaliate.
We have obtained the use of Alcatraz Prison, located on a precipitous island in San Francisco Bay, more than a mile from the shore. The current is swift and escapes are practically impossible.
Alcatraz, the rock, transformed from a military installation and stockade into a different kind of fortress. Toolproof bars covered every window. Electric doors were installed and guards conducted headcounts almost hourly. Life on the rock held few privileges. No newspapers, radios, or magazines. This prison broke the most hardened of criminals. Jim Quillen was Alcatraz prisoner number 586. He was only 22 years old when he arrived. Now he's written about his experiences. Today he's a volunteer on the island.
Supposedly there are two or three people who have never been seen, have never been heard from. There is a theory, a school of thought that says they made it, they're gone, they're somewhere out there. What's your feeling about it, having been here?
There's five, actually, that they have never found their bodies. The first two were Rowan Cole, that was in the late 30s, and then the Anglin brothers in the 60s. Roe and Coe went from the old industrial building, had 5-gallon cans strapped on their back for buoyancy. The guys from the hospital watched them go under, never come up. One can came up.
When you think about a sports event taking place here, starting here, and an impossible sports event at that, is that just a completely incongruous thought to you?
No, I can understand the challenge, you know, because of the mystique of this island, the fact that the five are missing, the fact that it's supposed to be impossible, the supposed sharks in the bay. No, I think it's a real challenge for people, and if I were 10 years older or younger, I'd like to do it, and I really would.
Well, it's a tough race for dogs, too, not only people. That's Summer, 4 years old, with Dave Horning, who's the race director here. Summer is a very experienced swimmer. I can promise you one thing, Frank, Summer will not be in the bike portion of the race.
Hey, let's not give Dave Horning any ideas.
Meanwhile, the finish line fast approaching for Rip Esselstyn, but like a bad cold, he just can't shake Simon Lessing.
Next, an extra transition, put on the running shoes, out to the end of Muni Pier, back up over a very steep hill to Fort Mason and the bicycles.
And coming to the end of the swim, Rip Esselstyn is going to win this battle, but the war for him may be just about over.
It took everything he had, I think, to come out of the water first. Here's the challenge. Get your wetsuit off. It hasn't been covering your hands. They're frozen. No one can help you. How do you do it standing up without falling over?
Simon Lessing behind him, and he'll be giving chase.
The clock you see, 29, 30. That's the interval we're taking here on the transition. Who gets the shoes on first? Who starts the mile run? Rip Esselstyn off first. He always tries. Usually he's on the bike by now.
Wes Hobson out of the water in third place. Have a little trouble there.
And here, Simon Lessing already going to go by. Rip Esselstyn, you can tell who's the pure runner. Oh, look, a little tap there.
Mike Pigg in third place. Hobson still having problems with that zipper. Here's Andy Kelsey and Greg Welch between them. First woman out of the water already, McKeely Jones, very impressive. And in front, Simon Lessing. Mike Pigg out of the transition area and off on the run. And Rip Esselstyn slowly becoming a non-factor. Wes Hobson, a slow transition for him. He's in fourth place, and Greg Welch behind him.
But out on the pier, you can see that Lessing already, within a quarter of a mile, has about a 30-yard lead on Rip Esselstyn.
And McKeely Jones off on the run. Big lead early in the race. Here's Paula Newby-Fraser, second woman out of the water.
McKeely Jones already 600 yards into the run.
Paula Newby-Fraser second, Holly Naibo in third place. Simon Lessing now down the stairs toward the bike transition at Fort Mason and Rip Esselstyn.
Simon Lessing from Great Britain, just how good is he in the transitions? He's 23 years old. This is so tough. You have to stop running, get your helmet on, and you have to snap that helmet or you're disqualified. No one can help you with your bike. Get on there. He will not put his feet in the bike shoes yet. He'll pedal out with his feet on top of the shoes. He'll get some momentum. He's trying to slip one in there now. Rip Esselstyn behind him. Usually Rip is the first on the bike. Today, he is second.
And the rest of the lead men. Greg Welch, a good run. Hobson right behind him and Pig right behind him. Welch always quick in transition. He's gone. And there goes Pig.
Mike Pig right behind his training partner, Greg Welch, but they're racing now.
And they're chasing this man, Simon Lessing, on the lead.
Warm up those legs. Don't go too hard yet. Rip Esselstyn still doesn't have his feet in the shoes.
And back at the transition, McKeely Jones. Quick transition for her.
Big lead. The thing here is don't go too hard, don't go too fast, because you slip up. And again, have they warmed up after that 1 mile run? She's a little bit tentative, but she knows she's got a good lead. She's been looking around when she's been running.
So McKinney Jones is the leading woman. Simon Lessing is the leading man. And as he told Greg Lewis, this is a race unique to itself.
I think it's a pretty exciting race. It's distances that we're not really used to, because the distances are fairly different compared to a standard race.
Simon Lessing is meticulous in his race preparation. As a short course specialist, he knows everything relies on precision. And so far, it's paid off. He's been unbeatable. But this is his first attempt to escape from Alcatraz.
I think it kind of suits me because I'm a fairly good swimmer. I should come out of the swim basically in the lead. The idea is just to hang in on the bike and the run, which is my strong point, so hopefully I can make a break there.
And that's exactly what he's doing right now. Everybody trying to keep up with Lessing. Amongst the women, trying to keep up with Jones.
How do you know? Who do you trust? What do they really say? Only one long-distance company gives you written proof that your business saves over AT&T. There's no question about savings with MCI's Proof Positive.
Well, sure, my business is saving with AT&T. At least I think so. I feel that we are. I'm sure that we are. How would I know if we weren't? I don't think we'd know. I don't know if we're saving.
There's no question about savings with MCI's Proof Positive.
It's got energizing carbohydrates, important vitamins and minerals, more of what you need to improve performance and speed recovery. Ultra Fuel Energy Drink. Fuel up and drive your body to the max. Buy it at fine health food stores, gyms, and wherever sports drinks are sold.
You're a teenager and you're pregnant. You're a teenager and you're going to be a father. You want to have a healthy baby. Who can you talk to? Where can you go for help? Help is available. Call the United Way of Massachusetts Bay at 617-422-6780.
This is a different kind of museum with a different kind of fun and experience for young and old. This museum collects trolley cars. It has the world's largest collection of trolleys of different sizes, colors, from different cities and countries. There are no museum guards telling you not to touch the collection. We tell you to get on our collection and ride the trolleys. Your admission allows you to ride as many trolleys as you want. Ride back into transportation history. Seashore Trolley Museum, Route 1, Kennebunkport, Maine.
This segment is brought to you by Twin Lab, makers of Ultra Fuel, the official sports drink of the Escape from Alcatraz Triathlon.
Welcome back to the Escape from Alcatraz. Simon Lessing now with almost a minute on a very tightly bunched field. Mike Pigg 50 seconds back, Hobson and Welch within 3 seconds of Pigg. And that is Lessing on his way up the hill. He's gone just past the entrance to the Golden Gate Bridge, still into Presidio. Pigg riding very comfortably right now in second place. Hobson in third place and Welch in fourth place. And the three of them, interestingly enough, live in the same town, Boulder, Colorado. Two of them under one roof. A little bit of real world.
This is a true story.
Of five triathletes.
All living under one roof.
And what happens when the training stops?
And the craziness begins.
All right, cooking dinner.
Forget cycling, running, and swimming. The main event around here is eating.
Dinner in our house is pretty exciting, especially if we're all in there at the same time.
Now is the time for cutting and cutting up. Welcome to the pig house. Not P-I-G pig, but P-I-G-G.
Piggies! Piggies everywhere.
The type with an insatiable appetite for victory. Three-time Escape from Alcatraz champion Mike Pigg shares his summer home with his wife Marcy and several other athletes, including Sean and Greg Welch.
Sean and Greg are like our couple from Disneyland.
Marcy!
Marcy, on these underwear.
Greg's usually always up. I'd rather see him down. I mean, the whole household is always up. There's someone on cloud nine that just brings everyone to that level, which is kind of nice. It's hard to have one person down in this house.
Dinner is served.
Oh, that time.
Dinner times are the best. Everybody kind of feeds off each other's energy, and there's never a dull moment in our house.
To our summer family.
Mm. Our summer family.
Yeah, to our summer family.
Would it be fair for me to say that this relationship sort of transcends friendship, transcends respect, transcends, use the word, camaraderie? Is it more than that? Is there...
That sums it up pretty good.
Yeah, I think all those words would be a really good way of describing all of us here. We're one household.
I don't know about room pricing.
Well, something is fueling Mike Pig right now. He is riding extremely well in chase of Simon Lessing. Let's go to the stop pace car and Greg Lewis.
Barry, the expression on Mike Pig's face is total ferocity. He's on a charge. At the Lincoln Park Golf Course, he trailed Simon Lessing by about 50 seconds. Now, at the turnaround, he's but 20 seconds back. Cycling is Pig's strongest discipline. It's all or nothing time.
This is so suited to Mike Pig. The chase group behind him, he's now got his sights set and in his mind ready to blow by Simon Lessing. Meanwhile, McKelly Jones warming up her bike legs. She's going a little smoothly here, just trying to get the swim out of her legs and get into her rhythm. She doesn't even know, I think, how much of a lead she has on this woman, Paula Newby Fraser. Just getting on her bike, and Barry Tompkins is down there watching.
Well, there goes Paula Newby Fraser. She is almost 3 minutes behind the leader, McKelly Jones, right now. But remember, the bike portion is her strongest portion. She's going to have to make it up there because both Jones and Newby Fraser are just about equal in the run. She's got some catching up to do, and she's going to have to do it right now.
Meanwhile, back at Aquatic Park, the cold water is taking its toll. And there's Sean Welch. She's got her shoes on. It appears that previous injuries prevented her from running.
How are you doing?
I just have a foot injury, so I had to drop out my first run. Thanks.
She was unsure she could run. She had a pain in her arch, and obviously the cold water didn't help it.
Well, the cold water continuing to claim a few victims. The Sea-Doo Rescue Unit out there following the swimmers all the way from Alcatraz, picking up some of those who can't make it to the finish line. And you do have to say it's a fashionable way of arriving at Aquatic Park. Simon Lessing on the lead, but he's got company. Mike Pig has caught him.
And instead of going by, they ride together. This is the bicycle version of sizing each other up. And finally, Mike Pig makes a burst. Just like in the Tour de France, the climber takes off up over the top, down the hill, and now Lessing has to catch back up.
Wake up!
Oh, and he's down.
And down hard.
No!
Oh, that's more than simple road rash. That's a deep cut. Road rash is when you just sort of bury yourself on the side, you clean that up, it heals up. That's not going to heal for a while. Oh, when you're so stiff and you're kind of in shock, he's checking his bike, make sure it's okay.
Is he all right? Yeah, he was getting down. He's got some rash on him, but...
And that really tells you everything you need to know about these triathletes.
Well, they're a community. I mean, you know, one of theirs has gone down. But now he knows Simon's all right. I mean, Mike's gone down before. He's going to put down his head and ride as hard as he can.
Well, the good news for Lessing, apparently his equipment is at least all right.
Well, when he went down on the left side of his bike, and the derailleur and everything is on the other side. So the bad luck is to go down. The good luck is he can still get back up on his bike.
And it's all downhill now for Mike Pig. The bad luck is Simon Lessing's. The good luck is Mike Pig's. We'll be back. Will Simon Lessing.
You could play in the rain. You could frolic in the snow.
shines, you could peel off the rest of your inhibitions. The Saab 900 convertible. Find your own road. Saab.
Where do germs live that surround your gums and teeth? Plaque. Think you're immune? Take the plaque scratch test. Scratch a tooth up by your gum line. We won't look. That film is plaque. It's a magnet for germs. That's why you should remove it with Advanced Formula Plaque, the only brand proven to loosen and remove more plaque before you brush, and thousands of germs with it. Advanced Formula Plaque. Remove more plaque.
Saucony doesn't make a lot of noise. Just great fitting running shoes.
Saucony, loyal to the sport.
Wake up, call 1-976-WAKE. Get out of bed and get ahead. Use your touchtone phone. Call 1-976-WAKE. We're the wake up that works. So why worry about being late again? Call 1-976-WAKE. Do it now. Only $2 per call. Depend on us. Call 1-976-WAKE and wake up right. Wake up right. Wake up to us tomorrow. For service outside Massachusetts, call 1-900-976-WAKE.
For Jimmy Valvano, basketball was life. On April 28, 1993, he was thrown out of the game forever. The same fate awaits one out of every five basketball players, one out of every five basketball fans, and one out of every five people watching this message. That's how many of us will be thrown out of the game early by cancer. To learn what's being done to prevent and cure cancer, call the National Coalition for Cancer Research, 1-800-9-RESEARCH.
We welcome you back to San Francisco. I'm Barry Tompkins, along with Olympic marathon gold medalist Frank Shorter, who incidentally now participates in Masters multi-sports events. More relevant to this event that we're watching, Greg Lewis is out amongst them. This is GGP's coverage of the escape from Alcatraz. Mike Pink leading the escape right now, taking advantage of the fall by Simon Lessing. And amongst the women, Makili Jones with a healthy lead over Paula Newby-Fraser. Holly Naibo is right now in third place. This is an event that is just not for the faint of heart. Cold water claiming victims. And the transition, not always smooth. Injuries, just a way of life for triathletes, even the best. To talk about it than to do it.
And Simon Lessing just trying to hang on. That's deep. But does he feel it? My guess is he's more mad than hurt right now. And here's Mike Pink, already at the fight to run transition.
I got it. All the way to the end. Mike.
A little bit of confusion here. Pink now straightened out.
Number one!
Mike Pick knows this is not over yet. He has no idea how far ahead he is, and he knows Simon Lessing is a better runner.
Which way out?
41 seconds on the transition for Mike Pick. Makili Jones continues to have it her own way. She's a lady with a plan.
My strategy is to have a good swim, have a good bike, and be well out in front and for them to chase me down. I mean, that would be an ideal race plan, but, you know, you never know what's going to happen. And if things don't turn out, well, you know, I'm going to tough it out like everyone else.
In classic Aussie understatement, good seems to mean better than everyone else.
Simon Lessing now at the transition to the run.
And he's running well. That's what's important. What did that fall do to his leg? He seems okay.
Going strong.
Where's Pig?
Go back. You got it.
About a minute and a half up,
Simon.
Which way?
Out to the right.
Out to the right. Take your helmet off.
Lessing is out right now.
Not bad news for Simon Lessing. Minute and a half on a 10-mile run. Pretty good odds for him.
And here's the man he's chasing, Mike Pigg, running now on Baker Beach. There's a lot of this run that takes place on the sand. He's not yet reached the turnaround point of the San Francisco Presidio. Greg Lewis has the story of this place that's gone from first line of defense to newest national park.
Tucked away in the northwest corner of San Francisco lies an aging military installation that feels more like a sanctuary than a fortress. Established by the Spanish in 1776, the Presidio didn't always look like this.
In the beginning, this was a really harsh post. In the 1850s, a U.S. soldier would not look forward to being stationed here. In fact, in the 1860s or 1850s, a lot of them were deserting to look for gold.
To make their assignment a little more desirable, the U.S. Army refurbished the small post, expanding the barracks, providing transportation to the city, and most impressively, changing the landscape forever.
Trees were planted by the thousands in the 1870s, 1880s. Ironically, most of them were actually imported from Australia, being eucalyptus trees, so they don't in any way reflect the natural history of California.
Government budget cuts have forced military base closures, and the Presidio was not spared. Recently, it officially closed as a military installation. While a small outpost of Army personnel prepare to leave, the National Park Service prepares to take over to provide security and preserve the rich military history and majestic beauty of the Presidio.
It's a place of beauty, a place of history, a place of nature and recreation that you don't find, you know, all together in one place. Anywhere in the United States.
We're way out.
Wes Hobson now still doing very well in third place.
Wes Hobson out of the transition right now.
And Greg Welch, he'll be able to run on through because he had platform pedals on his bike, allowing him to wear his running shoes. Watch how quick he is. Seems to me that Mike Pigg, at this point in his career, is trying not only to win this race, but to maintain his position in the triathlon hierarchy.
Just turn around. Around here. What? Yeah,
I just locked the knockoff Simon Lessing one time. But he's what the future of triathletes are going to be for the Olympics, and I'd like to beat him one more time before I get a little bit too slow to do the two-hour event.
Simon Lessing now coming to the turnaround, and he has Mike Pigg in his sights.
Meanwhile, back at the run transition, McKeely Jones has increased her lead a little on Paula Newby Fraser. There's no other way to put it. She's having a great day. This is the moment, the pass. Will Simon Lessing just wait there? No, he'll go by. You press, get as much of a lead as you can, relax, hope the man doesn't come back on you. Mike Pigg, he's going to stare into Simon Lessing's back and saying, hold on. The race might be over, were it on the flat.
But it is not. Still ahead, this, the toughest portion of the course. We'll be back.
It's that time of year again, Visine season. The time for red, burning, irritated eyes. The season when your eyes need all the help they can get. The season for Visine. Of all the eye drops you can buy, Visine is the only one recommended by pharmacists 4-to-1 over any other brand. It's so effective, it gives you 100% of the relief you need. So red, irritated eyes feel 100% refreshed. Remember, it's Visine season. Better get Visine. It gets the red out.
How do you know? Who do you trust? What do they really say? Only one long-distance company gives you written proof that your business saves over AT&T. There's no question about savings with MCI's Proof Positive.
Sure, my business is saving with AT&T. At least I think so. I feel like we are. They tell us we are. How would we know if we weren't? I don't think we'd know. I don't know if we're saving.
There's no question about savings with MCI's Proof Positive.
Television is changing. More channels, more choices. But who can you count on to cover the landscape of local news? News about Greater Boston and all of New England?
News Center 5,
News Center 5.
News Center 5.
Still New England's number one choice.
Today's late-breaking stories reported by people you know and trust. We'll be there for you.
You can count on it.
News Center 5. Coverage you can count on.
From people you can trust.
We choose to go to the moon in this decade and do the other things. Not because they are easy, but because they are hard. Because that challenge is one that we're willing to accept, one we are unwilling to postpone, and one we intend to win.
He wasn't the first politician to promise the moon, but he was the first to deliver it.
We're in the run portion of the Escape from Alcatraz right now. The weather conditions pretty much as they were. It is cloudy, it is overcast, but the fog is lifted, and it's not horrible conditions for these runners. Take a look at the leaderboard. One thing, of course, all these runners are going to have to think about, and that is dehydration. And to that end, I'm joined by Dr. Ed Burke, an expert in nutrition. And Ed, let's talk a little bit about the fact you were saying earlier these runners can actually lose up to 2 liters of liquid.
Besides the competition, these athletes are competing at such a high intensity that it's not uncommon for athletes at this type of level of competition to lose up to 2 liters. So they must consciously stop at the aid stations to take in fluids and drink some carbohydrate drinks to ensure that they will finish safely and at their best performance levels.
Well, the race is between Lessing and Pig, but Brett Welch starting to loom up at the turnaround. And the women's race to the swiftest and the strongest.
It's become a tradition in major triathlons to insert some unique features, and this is definitely one. I would term this the Baker Beach Equalizer. This is kind of a log carpet laid up a very steep beach. The athletes will have to concentrate each time they put their foot down in order not to trip coming up here, and you can't understand how steep it is until you see them laboring with every step. But I think if they can get to the top here, take a turn around, both the men's and women's leaders, and not see anyone back there behind them, it'll be their race.
The race is on the beach now. There's the leader, Simon Lessing. In second place, Mike Pigg. And starting to make a move, Greg Welch.
Who would have believed at the start of this race there would be 3 men on this ladder at the same time?
Any one of these three can win it. Greg Welch, right now, may be the strongest of the three. Well, the race is joined, and Greg Lewis, what does it look like from your viewpoint?
From our vantage point in the Saab pace car, Barry, we are seeing a race that changes back and forth. The storyline continues to unfold. Simon Lessing had a lead of about 150 yards down on the shore. As they came back up onto the road, Mike Pigg had cut it to about 75 yards. Pigg is concerned he can't run as strongly as Lessing, but Lessing has those wounds from the bike crash. With about 3 miles to go, the race is as tight as it's ever been for Mike Pigg as he goes for title number 4.
So there are the leaders, 38 seconds separating 1 from 3. The finish line looms. We'll be back.
Sega's new World Series Baseball 95 is so realistic, you can actually watch the ball come off the bat, which lets you react instantly so you can be ready for just about anything.
Hey, Ricky!
It's got energizing carbohydrates, important vitamins and minerals, More of what you need to improve performance and speed recovery. Ultra Fuel Energy Drink. Fuel up and drive your body to the max. Buy it at fine health food stores, gyms, and wherever sports drinks are sold.
You could take 49 cubic feet of junk mail, old tax returns, and all that other baggage. Launch it off a treacherous mountain road. And bid it a fond farewell. The Saab 900. Find your own road. Saab.
Can you tell which person has lupus? Neither can we, because most people with lupus look healthy. Most don't know they have a serious autoimmune disease because symptoms can vary. They're often internal and can mimic other diseases, like low-grade fever, joint pain, exhausting fatigue, and sun sensitivity. Ask about lupus. Call the Lupus Foundation at 617-332-9014.
Now a Success by Six parenting tip from Nurse Jean.
Pets can be loyal and affectionate playmates for you and your children, but don't assume your pet loves your baby or toddler as much as you do. Never leave a small child alone with an animal. You just don't know what the child will do or how the animal might react. They can have fun together as long as you're right there with them.
For more information, call the United Way of Mass Bay at 422-6780.
You can't leave San Francisco without visiting the great restaurants. The chefs of Chow took care of the wine and the dine, while event VIPs filled up on a fabulous contemporary Italian meal. Also this week, Pulse magazine presented the 24-hour Nautilus Rockin' Fitness Fest. It looked like a who's who of the fitness industry. Everywhere, people crowded into the Marina Green for plenty of free food and fun. Even the triathletes got in on the action. Scott Tinley powered up his autograph arm.
Yeah, you're in good company.
Yeah, look at the pants.
And the number one U.S. pro, Wes Hobson, explained the finer points of training.
And Wes Hobson utilizing those fine points right now. He still is not totally out of the hunt. Just over a minute behind the leaders and now coming to that all difficult portion of this race course. Up the ladder. And then when you get to the top of the ladder, you've still got an uphill. Simon Lessing now, 14 seconds gap between he and Mike Pigg. And Greg Welch has narrowed it by 14 as well. He trails by just 24 seconds. Here's what is ahead now for Simon Lessing. He starts a long downhill portion, but there's some interesting obstacles. You've talked about what a unique course this is, Frank. Look what's ahead for him.
Through the tunnel. He has to be far enough ahead, I think, to be out of sight, because you can really work on your lead if you're a front runner and you're that far ahead, but 14 seconds is really not that much. I think Mike Pigg can actually, at this point in the race, be catching glimpses of Lessing out ahead of him.
So it could be the last hurrah for Mike Pigg. He loves the rough terrain, and he's on it right now. So Lessing is the leader, Pigg is the chaser, and Welch is coming. It's the last aid station.
Now we start timing the lead, because he'll be out of sight a little bit ahead of Mike Pigg around this corner. We see how far behind Mike is. 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 seconds behind at this point. That's nothing in a race like this.
Greg Welch in third place.
At this point you're saying, give me some water. How far ahead are they? He's off. Mike's saying to himself right now, I just got to get close enough so I can see him. You got to see him. just in the back, you can see Mike Pig.
Tough downhill, always putting the brakes on, jarring to the knees.
And here comes Pig. He's flying down this hill. Look at this. Just about 6 seconds at that point.
And Welch, you didn't have to duck to get under that tunnel. And now they come to the final flat. They'll run on the beach again here.
Seemed to me all through the race, Mike Pig, who's a power runner in my estimation, would gain on Simon Lessing, who, even though he's a much bigger athlete, is really a form runner. He's more of a track-trained runner. So Simon Lessing is thinking to himself, I need to get back on that bike path to the finish line. I just have to survive this last little bit of beach, and I'll tell you, he's not going to turn around.
Well, the gap is now narrowed to about 7 seconds, and what's going through Simon Lessing's mind? Get me off the beach and on to the hard flats, and I'm gone. One last look behind, and then what's ahead is the sweetest part of any race for any athlete. Simon Lessing, bloodied but not bowed, is the winner of the Escape from Alcatraz Triathlon. And a creditable second to Mike Pig.
Can't come any closer than this. He knew he was outrun by a better runner, but I think if there had been maybe 300 yards more of beach, it may have been different.
Tell me, how difficult was this race? It was your first time, yet you managed to win under what would seem to be very difficult circumstances.
Yeah, unfortunately, I was feeling pretty good in the swim, and I was really feeling strong on the bike and ready. For me, the idea was just to let Mike catch up and ride with him and finish with him off the bike. Unfortunately, around one of the corners, there were a whole lot of cars, and I couldn't see the corner that well, and I slid on some wet paint and just slid across the road and kind of tore myself up a bit, so it was really difficult to get back in.
Well, it was a brilliant run. It was a brilliant and very hard-fought race, especially with these terrible wounds.
Thank you.
Greg Welch finishes third, and right now Greg Lewis is with second place finisher Mike Pig.
Mike, number four was close, but not quite close enough.
I gave it my best shot. He had a little misfortune out there. That gave me a little ace in the hole, but I still can't pull it off. Simon's a strong, strong runner. But I'm still really happy with my performance.
Second today, but still a champion by everyone's terms here.
Keep on working at it. Thanks.
Well, the laurels aren't all for Simon Lessing. Save a little something for McKeely Jones. We'll be back.
National Car Rental gives you what others don't. A choice. Choose your car right on the lot from the car class you've reserved. It's that easy, and it's only at National.
As it turns out, the only people who bring more to running are the runners themselves. Saucony, loyal to the sport.
You could never wear a suit again. You could not laugh when it's not funny. You could go off and write that novel, climb that mountain, buy those shoes. You could fly in the face of convention. Or drive there. Find your own road. Saab.
This summer, it's the best way to get to the Franklin Park Zoo with the new Boston Gas Zoomobile, powered by natural gas. The Franklin Park Zoo offers many exhibits, including the African tropical forest, with over 300 animals from the forests of Africa. The Zoomobile leaves daily from 10 to 2 at Faneuil Hall and Copley Square. For more information on the Zoomobile, call the Franklin Park Zoo, 442-2002.
The Urban League of Eastern Massachusetts has free classes for those who want to prepare for the work world. Whether you need a GED, need a job, or skills training, we can help. Classes start the beginning of every month. So call the Urban League's Employment Resource Center, 442-4519 today, and get ahead now.
Transportation provided by Carey Limousine, offering chauffeur-driven limousines and sedans in 60 countries and 6 continents. For more information and reservations, call 1-800-336-4646.
As to the women's race, well, for all the 10, it was over shortly after the horn sounded back at the island of Alcatraz. Makini Jones swam away, rode away, then ran away from Paula Newby Fraser. Fraser, a distant second, this was a day for Makini Jones. And she is with Greg Lewis.
Keely, congratulations on first place in your very first time in this race.
Yeah. It was certainly cold out there in the water, and on the bike it was tough. We had a bit of a headwind, and you know, I didn't know if I was going to make 10 miles. I haven't ran 10 miles all season, so it was sort of nice. It felt great the whole way.
Well, now we know why you are the champion you are, and if you can run it blind and get first place, more power to you. Congratulations again.
Thank you very much.
Well, once more, a look at the winners. Makini Jones over Paula Newby Fraser and Holly Naibo, and how. In the men, Simon Lessing is a winner over Mike Pigg. Close race, Greg Welch finishes third.
The Escape from Alcatraz Triathlon has been brought to you by Saucony, proud to be the official shoe of the Escape from Alcatraz Triathlon. Saucony, loyal to the sport. By Ultra Fuel, the ultimate carbohydrate energy drink from Twin Labs. And by Saab, find your own road. Clothing provided by Bad Boy Apparel Company, the guts to be real. Accommodations provided by Hyatt Regency San Francisco Airport, home of Knuckles Historical Sports Bar, the best sports bar in the Bay Area. The number one choice for triathletes around the world is Triathlete Magazine. Subscribe to Triathlete, the only source you need.
Well, there weren't only two winners. There were about 500 winners. Anybody who made it from Alcatraz to Aquatic Park, up through the hills of the Presidio on a bike, and then made the 10-mile run back to the Marina Green. This was a day to remember. It was literally a day of ups and downs, with the course and sometimes with the competitors. In the end, a look into the future of this sport. To Simon Lessing and Makini Jones, go the spoils. For all of us, my partners Frank Shorter and Greg Lewis, I'm Barry Tompkins. See you next year.
Travel provided by Southwest Airlines. Fly Southwest, the low-fare airline. This has been a presentation of GGP.
Television is changing. More channels, more choices. But who can you count on to cover the landscape of local news? News about Greater Boston and all of New England?
News Center 5.
News Center 5.
News Center 5.
Still New England's number one choice.
Today's late-breaking stories reported by people you know and trust. We'll be there for you.
You can count on it.